growing food all year round with extreme microclimate change. We're in the Daleys Biodome in Kyogle, northern New South Wales, Australia, and it's a pretty extreme climate here. We get 46, 47 degrees Celsius in summer, and we can get down to -5, -6 degrees Celsius in winter. So we've got this extreme variation of climate, and we've definitely got an overlap of temperate and tropical climate conditions that we phase through, and that is reflected in our local ecology in the rainforest. Well, I'm in the biodome at Daleys, and as promised, I wanted to share a little video on how we created this really beautiful little dwarf food forest, perennial food production system. And one of the principles that I really want to sort of play with here and share that concept that we're working with is microclimate creation, tweaking and working with different microclimates. So of course we've definitely got an amazing microclimate inside an existing polytunnel. That's something that we've utilized, an old polytunnel that we wanted to maximize its grow potential. But we're also definitely working with this multi-strata, multi-layered food forest production. And you can see that we've got these, you know, some of the trees are around about 3 to 4 meters high. I like to keep them at about 3 meters. And some are even smaller, around 2 meters, 2 meters, and then understory perennial greens and different herbs and elements that take up that forest floor niche. So as we go for a little walk around and we see all the different types of fruit and greens that we can grow here, you can really feel into how it's a beautiful space and it's a beautiful way to grow fruit and grow food with minimal maintenance, minimal input. We really set this system up, and once it's at its full sort of successional stage, we can just keep pruning it and chop and dropping the prunings and keep maintaining it at that height that we want, and we'll get fruit production year after year for decades to come, which I think is pretty cool. So if you're interested in fruit tree production and you don't have a polytunnel, you can still mimic a system like this by keeping your plants dwarfed, pruned back to 3-4 meters max, and using that layered multi-strata technique that you can see around the food forest biodome at the moment. Thanks for watching. My name's Paul Daly. If you'd like to follow us, click the little button down the bottom and subscribe, and the little bell, and you'll get a notification when we have future videos on all things fruit production, fruit trees, and growing food in your backyard.